Well, hi everyone. I'm John Rethlin with a double review of two Shudder originals I just saw, Warning Do Not Play and 0.0 Megahertz. They're two South Korean horror movies, and I was really excited to see both of them. And I'm going to get into spoilers here in a little bit, but I'll tell you, one was okay and one wasn't very good at all. I do want to give a quick shout to Shudder, though. They have plenty of classic, you know, classic movies, cult movies, everything in between, plenty of originals, movies and series. Really, really great stuff. Cheap price. Please check out Shudder. They really are goddamn great. I've enjoyed being subscribed to them, you know, having my own subscription for at least, I'd say, 3 to 4 years. It really has been goddamn good, and it's so fucking worth it, and so cheap. But check it out if you're a horror movie fan, if you haven't already. So, and if you are a subscriber to Shudder, tell me some of your favorites, you know, whether originals or whatever, and stuff that you want me to check out. So, Warning, Do Not Play. Well, I misread the instructions and hit play. Might as well have called it Boring Padding the Musical. Let me make it clear that South Korean horror with its atmospheric feeling of dread usually can work. This just didn't. And the reason it didn't is because it was just stretched out to 85 minutes, but it was so boring. This would have been fine as a short film concept. I feel like I've said that in some other, you know, reviews that I've done. But you have a young female director who just can't get her horror project going. She just can't, and she's had a deadline set. And she finds inspiration from this one film that was apparently banned from a film festival because the director said, and I quote, "It was made by ghosts." Well, great. It was made by a ghost. Or multiple ghosts. Who the fuck knows what it was actually made by? But it's cursed. But the girl is so goddamn interested, she finds it, she puts it up on, you know, a post and says, "Anybody know about this? Anybody know about this?" Finally, she gets contacted by the director. He says, "Please take it down. Please take it down. You don't want to mess with this." Well, she doesn't. Until she talks to him. And then she talks to him. And then guess what happens? Things go inevitably tits up. We find out that the director was filming at the, you know, this abandoned theater where a woman died. And this woman haunts them. And now haunts this young female director. Here's the problem. I made the film sound much more interesting than it actually was. Now, yes, horror is subjective. Some people may find this frightening. Other people may not find this frightening. Other people may be incredibly bored like I was, and I feel bad because I think they could have done something good here, but, you know, this whole feeling of like, oh, well, you know, you shouldn't go messing with things that you shouldn't, you know, that you shouldn't be messing with. Don't mess with ghosts. They'll fuck with you and everything, and they'll kill you. Well, some people just don't listen and are so driven to make their project succeed, and that's pretty much what happens here. Everybody dies, but she finds the inspiration for her film project and is even filming at that same theater. And everything's good and everything, and then we cut the play. Look, the film just isn't very good. I mean, I'm sorry, it's just not. I know that it seems like I'm kind of like just describing the plot really badly, but it doesn't have much of a plot. What I described is pretty much it. They try the mind-bending things where she can see the people being killed in real time. So, oh no, something's like really scary. Oh no, is she being put in this reality? What's going on? Or is the ghost possessing her? What exactly is going on? The problem is all those scenarios are far more interesting than what the movie actually executes. And it's also not scary. It is unbelievably unscary. And that's a major disappointment. Even the atmosphere. The atmosphere lasts for a few minutes. And then it just gets really shit. The special effects aren't all that good. I mean, they just aren't. And I get it if a film has a cheap budget, but the special effects just weren't all that good. So, hate to say it, Warning Do Not Play gets an F because I was really bored. The worst indictment of a horror movie, besides not being scary, is just being incredibly bored by it. Now, was it as bad as The Grudge? Oh no, The Grudge remake was a whole lot worse. I'm talking the one that just came out in this January. I'm not referring to, you know, the Sarah Michelle Gellar or the Japanese version, but yeah, this was aggressively boring and it's unfortunate. So let's move on to something I didn't mind, 0.0 Megahertz. So, have you burned your ritualistic doll today? Well, you should, because otherwise you're going to end up like the people in this movie. There's a group of people called 0.0 Megahertz that are, you know, wanting to investigate this house in this old village, this old abandoned village where this woman died, because this ghost has been killing anybody that gets on the property. Because this ghost is tired of, you know, the fact that it is not being heard because there were people that tortured her. So, okay, she's a vengeful spirit that wants to torture everybody. So naturally, in doing the smart thing, they go there, these people go there, it's like three guys, it's two girls. One blonde girl that forgets to wear pants, so that's all. She actually wears shorts. But it's all good there. But at least they're a little bit smarter, and this one already has a much more tight focus. It is more atmospheric. It does have some cool moments to it, but the special effects also aren't all that good either. And that's another indictment of, like, you know, a cheaper rate for a movie like this. I get it. You want to cut costs and you want to do what you can and you want to maybe build around just the characters. But it only helps if you have characters, and this one doesn't. The guys are not distinguishable from each other at all. I honestly was losing track of who the characters were. The brunette girl and the blonde girl at least were a little bit distinguishable, or easy to distinguish, that is, because of their hair colors, but also because one ends up possessed and one ends up possessed, you know, by the good ghost. The one good ghost is trying to get rid of all this of all this evilness and stuff like that. And here's the main crux of the problem I have with this. Apparently it's based on a comic. I've never read the comic because I would have a hard time reading Korean comics. Apparently it's good. And from what I read in reviews, you're either going to love or hate this. That's the thing. I'm falling right in the middle on this one because the people end up finally leaving the place, but not before the blonde girl gets possessed and then they're haunted by the ghost and everything. And oh no, what the fuck is going on? Oh no, all this stuff. How can we take care of this? We were supposed to burn the doll and we didn't burn the doll. They just dropped it in the bucket and stuff like that. And it was ridiculous because they hung up the doll, do this ritual and everything and do this stuff. And this was also a little bit padded, but it wasn't as padded as an 85-minute movie. You know, the 85-minute movie that I just talked about, Warning, Do Not Play. I struggled to even remember what the fuck the title was, and I just talked about it a couple minutes ago. With this movie, it certainly has some moments where I'm like, okay, that's kind of tense. Ooh, that's some good shot. There's some good camera work in both of these movies. This one just pulls it off a lot better. Everybody, eventually, they manage to get rid of the ghost somehow, or do they? Because the ghost ends up possessing one of the guys, you know, after they go back to the house and everything. And he's publishing a book. But since the spirit's out, that means we're going to have a spirit that is a published author that's not Tom Clancy. Tom Clancy with his name all over the goddamn, you know, all over those goddamn video games. But anyway, I digress. I joke about that. This movie should have worked more than it did, but it wasn't nearly as bad as Warning, Do Not Play. I actually enjoyed this one a little bit. The ending was obvious, but it did have a cool feel to it and a bit of atmosphere, so I gotta at least give it a C. It was enjoyable there, but let me know what you think of both of these movies. Like, share, subscribe, Twitter handle in the description. I'm John Ritland. I'll see you soon.